Here in the U.S., we have one of the highest teen pregnancy rates in any other Western country. We also have millions of teenagers getting STDs every year. Today, I'm gonna provide you with the proper sex education that your school probably didn't.
Quand il me prend dans ses bras, il me parle tout bas, je vois la vie en rose.
Ew is exactly right. If y'all are hooking up and a guy gives you an excuse like,
"Oh, baby, we don't need a condom. It don't feel good. I don't feel connected to you spiritually."
Or,
"I'm allergic. I can't wear that."
Your response should be, "I smell cat." Right here, it says, "This condom does not contain natural rubber latex." What you allergic to then? What you should be allergic to is having babies. You can't be messing around not wearing condoms. Also, if someone says,
"Trust me, I'm clean, that's why we shouldn't need birth control."
Do not trust them. It's like trusting someone who doesn't wear their seatbelt, but they're like,
"Nah, get in, I'm a great driver."
Seriously? I'm different, yeah, I'm different. There are many women who take birth control for reasons other than preventing pregnancy. Reasons like trying to regulate their period or try to reduce cramps or menstrual pain. And birth control can even help treat acne. There are a lot of reasons that someone might be taking birth control, so do not jump to any conclusions. As for the Michael B. Jordan comment, well, I think we can all agree to that. Getting tested is super important because a lot of these STIs and STDs might actually not show any symptoms. They may be lying dormant, but then in a year they pop up. Or it might not pop up for you, but then for your friend Joe, it's burning his balls off. Sexually transmitted infections are no joke. Plus, you don't want to have to be that guy when you're hooking up with a girl and you have to be like,
"Yeah, girl, before we go further, I just want to let you know I got gonorrhea."
If you have to say something like that, she's gonna be gone. This ain't SpongeBob. Nobody wants to be growing barnacles or crabs down there. So please, wrap it up.
Hey, Queen. Girl, you have done it again. Constantly raising the bar for us all and doing it flawlessly. I'd say I'm surprised, but I know who you are.
Why she gotta do Michelle like
hey,
that?
Hey, Queen.
An IUD is a small plastic or copper device that's shaped like a T that is about the same size as a quarter. Come on, that cringy magic trick deserves a like. It's a great long-term solution to prevent pregnancy because the IUD stops sperm from reaching and fertilizing eggs. An IUD is in the uterus defending it, like, "Ain't no sperm getting up in here, suckers!" It's a super effective long-term birth control method because your chances of getting pregnant with an IUD is less than 1%. Plus, an IUD can last up to 12 years. But it's also removable, so if you want to get pregnant beforehand or take it out, you can do that too. It only takes one, boys. 4% chance is still pretty high, bruh. Imagine if your cum had a 4% chance of ruining your life. Would you want to take that chance? No. Make sure you are being careful with the pre-cum and the cum. Y'all tripping relying on the pullout method. So I'm gonna show you how to put on a condom. First things first, make sure your condom ain't expired. All right, 2023, easy. I wish 2020 was over already. Then open it. Do not use your teeth because you might accidentally bite and rip the condom open. Now you need your little wizard hat. So it needs to be like this. You see, it's a little wizard. You're a wizard, Harry. Don't have it like this. That ain't gonna do anything if it's upside down. This looks like a problematic hood. Don't do that. Pinch the top, put it on the penis, and then you roll it down. And don't be embarrassed if the girl seems like she's waiting, like, and it's taking forever. Don't trip. You need to make sure you take your time and do it right. If you did, you'll notice that there's this little bag still at the end. That's perfect. Look at this. Man, this looks like a real penis, bruh. I'm never gonna be able to wash dishes the same again. After you put the condom on, you might think, okay, now I'm ready to go to town. Hold on, cowboy. A lot of condoms come pre-lubricated, but it's a great idea to add your own lubrication. It'll really help increase your pleasure, and it will really help increase hers. Adding lube helps reduce friction and it increases pleasure. Now, don't make the same mistake I did and not read how big Amazon sizes actually are. That's a lot better. I really recommend a water-based formula because you won't have to worry about it destroying any sex toys. After you're done, you still need to be careful taking off the condom. You don't want all your hard work to go to waste. Make sure when you're pulling out, you grab the rim of the condom, so when you pull it out of her, it doesn't accidentally slip off and go inside her. Take it off carefully, making sure it's good, making sure there's no holes, no leaks. What I like to do is sometimes I would actually run it under a sink to see, you know, I make a little condom water balloon, and then if ain't no holes, ain't nothing popping out, I know I'm good. And then you just wrap that thing up, tie it in a knot, then yeet. Using a condom is a simple and effective birth control technique, so make sure you're using one every time you hook up. My favorite brand is definitely Skin. I really like the way it feels. It almost feels like it's not there. I definitely recommend you buy yourself a box. This one is a synthetic rubber kind of condom, which I like more because you don't have to worry about any allergies to latex. And if you're gonna use one of those sheepskin condoms, well, they don't actually protect against STIs effectively, so do not use those. I'm gonna leave this in the description box. It's heat. Now back to the compilation.
Why is everything chrome?
Cash. Man, this beat got me feeling like the franchise boy in this league. Lean with it, rock with it. Lean, swear, rock.
Please, if you don't want to be a parent, which you shouldn't, do not rely on the pullout method alone.
Nope.
If you don't want to listen to me and you just want to rely on the pullout method, well, I hope you're ready to pull up to that hospital when your baby being born. When it comes to preventing pregnancy, everyone's pullout game is weak.
Welcome to Watch Mojo, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 stupidest people in history.
And I get it, sometimes you're just in the heat of the moment, you're in that hot state where you don't think about what you should do rationally and you just feel the moment. Well, sometimes feeling the moment has consequences. Thankfully for her, she knew about Plan B, which is a morning after pill used to prevent unwanted pregnancy. Additionally, putting in an IUD immediately after you have unprotected sex can also help and be a more long-term effective birth control solution. Pregnancy is not something to be playing around with, so thankfully there is Plan B and it can work as an emergency contraceptive, but it's flawed. It doesn't protect against STDs and it is expensive. It is $40 to $50 for one pill.
Cry me a damn river. You should keep your pecker in your pants next time and you wouldn't have issues like that.
I feel like that's all of abstinence-only training. I'm not gonna sit here and tell you, hey, the best thing you should do is just never have sex. Don't do it. I understand wanting to have sex and also not wanting to have sex. I'd much rather you have sex, but do it safely. That means you need to have conversations before your friends with benefits turns into friends with headaches because she's pregnant. You need to be on the same page with the person you're doing things with. I don't care if you have sex or not, but if you're going to have sex, you need to do it safely. It's not the end of the world if you do mess up and have unprotected sex. I'd highly encourage you to follow all of those steps to make sure you can fix your mistake. Everyone makes mistakes, but what matters is what you do after that mistake. If you keep making the same mistake over and over and over again, that ain't a mistake anymore. That is a choice. I want you to make the right choice and have protected sex and be safe and always listen to consent. It's okay to make a mistake. Just don't let it become a pattern.
So shut your mouth and run me like a river. Shut your mouth, baby.
That is straight facts there. I wanted to briefly touch on abortion. A woman should be able to do whatever she pleases when it comes to her body. And there are many, many, many reasons for a woman to want an abortion, and all of them are valid. There is a lot of research showing the emotional damage a woman can suffer after she gets an abortion. I don't want any of my viewers to have to go through that and have to live with that guilt or shame. A woman should always have the right to choose what happens to her body. And we have the choice to engage in safe sex to prevent a woman from ever having to make that choice in the first place. Ultimately, sex can be a way for you to connect with your partner, and this sex ed compilation is just a brief tip of the surface. I don't want you to feel like you need to go out, put on a condom, and lose your virginity ASAP. No, the point of this video is to educate you on how to properly protect yourself if you do choose to have sex. Sex can be super fun and exciting, but it can also be real damaging and can change your life in an instant. If you choose to have sex, you gotta make sure you use protection, understand the risks, and of course, communicate with your partner. All right, peace.